一只 iPhone 的手机连接到你银行的账户，同时连接到你很多 APP 里头可以支付的各种不同 Apple Pay 等等。如果你的手机被偷了呢？在美国2023年，一堆人手机 iPhone 被偷了，密码被拿走了，而且透过一些特殊的科技方式，它进入了你的支票账户，它进入你的加密货币的账户，它进入你的储蓄账户，进入你的 Apple Pay 把你的钱给拿走了。方法是什么？华尔街日报做了一个调查报告，怎么做的呢？他到狱中里头去访问被抓到了一个大盗，说哎，你是怎么偷的？他就教他说我是怎么偷，我跟对方聊天，然后他就没有了心房，然后接着呢我就用一些方法就偷到了他的密码。下一个大家要注意，然后我就改变了里头的 Face ID。 很多人以为 Face ID 使他安全，刚好最不安全，因为一旦他改变了这个 Face ID 以后，他就取得了所有这只手机一切的控制权，透过 Face ID 已经变成是他的脸，他就直接进入你的所有的储蓄账户、支票账户、加密货币账户以及 Apple Pay， 把你的钱都领走了。我们来看这个华尔街日报所做出来的调查报告。
你的手机安全吗？
Aaron Johnson is due to spend the next several years at this high security prison because he stole hundreds of iPhones and from them hundreds of thousands of dollars. He exploited a vulnerability in Apple's software, the same vulnerability I've been investigating for the last year.
I was homeless. I didn't have nothing. Started having kids and needed money, so.I couldn't really find a job.
In cities across the country, thieves are using the iPhone passcode to get into stolen phones and loot their victims' bank accounts and money apps, and lock them out of their Apple accounts. Along with others, Johnson, seen here in red, would target people in and around bars in Minneapolis to get their phones and their passcodes.
I just watch them put it in.
What happens?
I say I have the drugs. They say they want the drugs.And I tell them, take my information down. The whole time I don't have any drugs. So as soon as the phone's in my hand, I just ask them what's the code, or I watch them put it in before they give it to me. And then I kind of just talk about other things.
Is there an age of person you're looking for when you're out?
College, because they're more partying and they're already drunk and don't know what's going on for real.
I interviewed a number of Johnson's victims, all men under 30.
I definitely had cocaine. They were like, do you want to buy some? And I was like, no.
Others told me Johnson would say he was a rapper and wanted to add them on Snapchat.
Just a Snapchat, like that just seems normal. When I open up the phone and I hand it to him to put in.
I lock the phone and then I tell him that it's locked or something wrong with your phone. It locked on me. And then that's when they, okay, no problem. 266 or 4 or something, or they just do it for me.
You ever videotape them?
Yeah, videotaped a lot of numbers.
Never did this...People say, hey, you took my phone?
Yeah, but by that time, it's already, I don't have it no more. So, what you
want? Who has it?
Whoever I pass it to.
因为 Johnson 有11名同伴，到手的当下就立刻转手他人了。
You've got the phone, you've got the passcode, what do you do next?
It's kind of like a bank robbery. You gotta be quick. You gotta go to the settings, and go to the iCloud, click reset password, and...Put the six-digit code in and make my own password. And then I turned on Find My iPhone.
这么一来，原用户不仅无法远程定位被盗手机，甚至无法删除被盗手机上的资料。
How fast were you changing Apple ID passwords?
Faster than you could say supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. 5-10 seconds. I got to that fast where I can do it just right there.
With the passcode, Johnson removed the owner's face from Face ID and enrolled his own, making it easier to gain access to saved passwords to bank apps. This is my phone, right? You've gotten to my settings. Where are you going from here?
So then I go add my face on there, on the Face ID verification. Now when you got your face on there, you got the key to everything.
So where are you opening?
Things that people thought were safe.
Like?
Savings, checkings.Cryptocurrency apps.
Venmo.
Venmo, PayPal, yeah. You don't need face for none of that. That's kind of little money. I'm trying to take as much as I can.
If Johnson couldn't unlock the apps with his face, he'd look elsewhere on the phone.
I just go through their notes, and the password to everything is in there. social security number, everything.
While victims were sleeping, Johnson would be draining money from their bank accounts.
Before 5 a.m., I would have everything transferred out of the bank. But then if some people have like credit line or something, that's when I would go shopping with it. Go get, you know, nice stuff. Go to Nordstrom.
By using Apple Pay?
Yeah, just by beeping. And my face on there, so all I gotta do is put my face on it and beep. And I can swipe for thousands of dollars. Clothes, shoes, you know, all type of stuff. Kids stuff.
There was one more trick to this scheme. After stealing the money, Johnson would erase the iPhone, yes, using the passcode and password, and sell it. Was there an average selling price of an iPhone that you would sell?
If it's a iPhone 14 Pro Max with 1 terabyte, I'd probably get like $900.
Here's the kicker. Johnson was using stolen Apple products and their Apple Pay function to buy more Apple products. He said he could make up to $20,000 a weekend just from selling the phones. Following our investigation into these widespread crimes, Apple created new security software. But you'll have to turn on the stolen device protection setting. When it's available in iOS 17.3, it will be off by default. If you don't turn it on, all of Johnson's tricks will still work. If you do turn it on, it adds a line of defense to your phone when you're away from home or work. A thief would need your face or fingerprint scan to change an Apple ID password. Then they'd need to wait an hour, and then again they would need your biometrics. Same goes for adding a new Face ID and disabling Find My iPhone. To access safe passwords, a thief would need your biometrics. Still, some apps like Venmo are vulnerable, and using Apple Pay to buy things would still work. Also, don't store your passwords in the Notes app. When you get out, you gonna forget about this trick?
It's gonna be new tricks out. But I don't want no parts of it.
德国在2023年正式进入衰退，这个原来是欧洲的经济火车头，也是欧洲最重要的经济体里头核心的国家，也是解决欧债危机里头最重要的领导国家，它正式陷入了衰退。衰退很大的一项原因是俄乌战争导致它的能源成本大幅的增加，在它的能源里头很大的结构是天然气还有再生能源，可是再生能源的成本非常的高，而天然气无法再从俄罗斯取得便宜天然气以后，它必须购买很昂贵的液化天然气，也就是从美国、从卡达、从各地运来的液化以后的天然气，它的整个能源成本大幅升高。那么德国本身的反核运动相当的强，所以德国并不追求核能电厂，因此它的电费成为拖垮这个国家，而且导致很多工厂外移的第一项因素。第二项很重大的一个因素呢，是他本身自己因此工厂外移了，所以他的预算呢变成没有办法编列太多，他的债务又比过去来的更高。这样的一个预算跟债务危机，其实在西方几个大国里头都出现，意大利早就如此，荷兰最近也变成这样，英国也如此，美国现在也是这样，但美国是有美元，而德国也变成如此，这时这个德国可以再投资再生能源，使它的技术可以发展的能力也受到了限制。德国想要做的不只是整个再生能源的转型，还有很多重要的改变，通通都因为没有足够的预算，还有债务太高。它的宪法里头对于整个预算的赤字跟债务是有宪法里头清楚的一个规定。这样状况之下的德国，它变成一直在进行它的恶性循环。而在德东地区，就是过去的东德地区呢，当地主要本来是生产煤炭的，目前为止德国也仍然依赖相当高的煤炭，因为它当地自己产褐煤，那是很肮脏的一种能源，但是它如果再把煤炭再废掉的话，第一个当地的煤炭工人没有工作，因为当地失业率已经非常高，而它的能源已经价格太高了，所以就没有废掉，因此环保人士也抗争。可是德东地区除了开采煤炭之外，它的整个经济就是相对德西地区就一直是比较弱的，所以在当地呢就掀起了另类革命党里头最重要的温床，就是极右派运动。德国现在的极右派运动呢，从过去很小的一个党，被梅克尔称之为德国的耻辱的党，到现在他可不可以领取宪法里头给予他的选举的公积金？德国的选举啊，不像我们台湾是 政治人物到处去募自己政治现金，因此就高度的受到企业界的政治现金影响了我们的政策品质。德国它是非常好的，是用公费选举的方法，可是他们说这个另类选举党可不可以用公费来选举，因为德国的宪法里头是反对这种极端主义种族主义的政党，他必要的时候可以解散这个政党。那现在的问题还没有到解散另类选择党，但可不可以使用选举公费，这现在都成了大议题。所以另类选择党的崛起主要是在德东地区失业率很高的地方，他已经得到的选票变成第二大党，超过24%左右。德国虽然在1月10号、1月11号有数百万人上街头反对这个令人可耻的极右派的运动，可是你就可以想象德国现在处境是什么。这也使得美国开始对于乌克兰的援助，因为和边境议题，就是反移民的边境议题，预算绑在一起，所以给乌克兰的援助呢，变成只剩下非常少数，变成个位数字。而德国本身对于援助乌克兰也因为它的债务跟预算赤字也变成变少了，这使得德国的一切都跟过去我们所看到的梅克尔主政时期的德国完全不同。
能源转型原来是肖兹内阁的旗舰政策，这也是绿党领袖哈贝克身兼副总理与联邦经济和气候部长的主要原因。换言之，借由能源转型带动德国工业升级，是肖兹内阁社民党、绿党和自民党同意联合执政的核心共识。
It's having a devastating impact because the German government no longer has the money that it needs to fund the climate projects that they were planning in order to reach the goals that you've outlined, and there is no easy way for them to find this money in the budget now.Because Germany has a deficit limit, they've put in what they call a debt break.
德国宪法规定的债务刹车，将公共赤字限制 GDP 的0.35%，是德国在2009年颁布的一项财政规则，是根据德国宪法基本法第109条第3款，旨在限制联邦政府的结构性预算赤字。并限制政府债务的发行。
They introduced the debt brake in 2009. That was during the financial crisis then, where Germany had spent tens of billions of dollars to prop up its banks. And there was a sense in the country then that they needed to keep the government from overspending.
德国长期以来一直是预算管理的典范，是欧元区的模范生。然而吊诡在于，正是这种一板一眼的严格管理使柏林陷入了困境。德国良好的信贷并不愁在金融市场借贷资金，但在宪法法院的否决之后，德国政府决定暂停借贷，拒绝增加债务。
And there's a lot of infighting, and we can see, the polls show that the parties that are winning from that infighting in the government are the parties, the conservative CDU-CSU and the far-right AfD. So the government is really under pressure to come up with his plan B and to communicate it effectively to its population.
联合内阁不但为了找钱焦头烂额，甚至恶化了三党之间的分歧。自民党坚决主张零赤字，而绿党和社民党则更倾向支持透过可能的增税来增加公共支出。但是要废除这项债务刹车的规定，需要2/3的联邦议员投票通过，这是不可能的。德国预算危机引起了欧洲各国极大担忧，因为德国政府无暇关注欧洲事务，包括是否继续提供500亿欧元援乌储备金。然而由于德国财政捉襟见肘，这些额外拨款可能无法实现，德国的阻碍可能会演变成欧洲的阻碍。
As well as toward establishing microchip factories and assisting the automotive industry. Will Germany succeed? And if not, will the country be threatened by industrial decline?
德国政府本来已经承诺将对投资到德国设厂的晶片业者提供庞大的国家支持，但被裁定禁止挪用的600亿欧元，其中也包含对英特尔和台积电的补助。业界忧心德国政府的承诺是否跳票。
Das zentrale Instrument des Bundes für den klimaneutralen Umbau unseres Landes bleibt der Klima- und Transformationsfonds. Aufgrund der Vorgaben der Verfassungsrichter verringern wir allerdings die Ausgaben des Fonds im nächsten Jahr um 12 Milliarden Euro. Im Finanzplanungszeitraum bis 2027 kürzen wir um etwa 45 Milliarden Euro.
在12月13日，就2024年的支出削减达成妥协，在最后一刻避免了明年1月发生财政停摆。
Umschichten im KTF und wir werden einsparen. Einsparen bei Bereichen, und da bin ich den Kollegen sehr dankbar,aus dem Bau- und dem Verkehrsministerium, aber natürlich auch in dem Bereich, den ich verantworte. Ich will zwei Beispiele nennen. Wir werden die Umweltprämie, also die Förderung für E-Mobile, auslaufen lassen, früher beenden. Sie läuft ja eh aus, aber wir werden das früher tun.
Wir setzen den Kurs der fiskalischen Konsolidierung fort. Im Jahr 2021 hat die deutsche Schuldenquote 69% betragen. Im nächsten Jahr ist prognostiziert 64%. 2021 hatten wir ein Jahresdefizit von 3,6%.
肖兹也公开表示，他知道乌克兰战争不会那么快结束，所以将继续提供必要支持。
Die Unterstützung der Ukraine stemmen wir aus dem Regelhaushalt, so wie wir es geplant haben, und vor allem so lange wie nötig.
在联合内阁就2024年预算达成一致后，德国股市指数并未受到影响。收盘时甚至小涨了29点，并在保障支援乌克兰资金和社保支出的前提下，填补了宪法法院裁决造成的171亿欧元预算缺口。所有欧元区后段班债台高筑的国家，都靠着德国撑起的欧元不倒信誉，在金融市场上借贷。但德国不是美国，最终还是选择了坚守严格的公共财政规则，进行了痛苦的预算削减。2023年台湾选出的代表字是缺，德国今年选出的代表字不是危机，而是回应危机的危机模式。